Respected dignitaries, a very good morning. I'm Shruti Kukreti, and today I'll be discussing on the topic Nepotism on Professionalism. I hope you will like it. Our great beloved actor Sushant Singh Rajput has recently passed away on 14 June 2020. It has been alleged that he committed suicide because of depression and career-related tensions. But it is not something which is new. Many Bollywood celebrities, they commit suicide because of lack of work. But one thing which comes to my mind is, what actually causes this lack of work? Because every day I hear about two or three movies releasing one day or the other. Now I would like to use a very infamous term which we call nepotism. Yes, gentlemen. Nepotism is the practice of promoting and favoring jobs to friends and family by the one who are in power. Many directors and producers have been accused of favoring jobs to the star kids in their movies. Now this time, because of this suicidal case, the youth has taken a strong stand against these nepotism supporters and they have criticized them a lot. But one of the most disappointing points in this whole scenario is that people only acknowledge the nepotism which is related to the film industry. Gentlemen, nepotism is not only related to the film industry, it can be seen anywhere, be it politics, be it film industry or an official setup. Now talking about the politics, one of the most classic example of nepotism in politics is that we all know, Gandhi family and their International Congress. Yes, gentlemen. The Gandhi family have always been accused of promoting and favoring their heirs to the chief party candidate of the Indian National Congress, Mulayam Singh Yadav, founder of Samajwadi Party. He is also accused for the same. Many industrialists and businessmen, they too promote and practice this nepotism. If this happens, our India would become a country where people prefer reserved people rather than deserved people. Unemployment rates would increase, they would reach heights, and our country would lose its glory. Then what should be done? Being a citizen of our India, we have to take a strong stand against this lamentable injustice. As said, only worthy shall possess the power, not the reserved one. I do not completely refer nepotism as something which is unlawful, because sometimes it helps in yielding out a real talent. But favoring job to an unworthy instead of a deserving person is absolutely incorrect. It is wrong. And we have to take a stand against them. So our motive should not only be limited to terminating nepotism, but also to support the one who is deserving. And if this happened, our country would definitely lead to a bright and a beautiful tomorrow, and its future could be preserved. Respected dignitaries, this brings me to the end of my presentation. A big thanks to all of you.